Let's see. What will I learn about today? Okay, let's learn about strong and stable structures. I know. I'll build a structure and test how strong it is. I forgot! There's no gravity! I'll call Structurefriend for advice. Hey, Structurefriend, can you help me with a construction project?
Sure, Cosmo. I love building things. You should see my tree fort.
How do you pick the right materials? There are so many to choose from.
Each material has different properties and is used for different functions. Steel is strong and long-lasting. Wood is lightweight. And concrete can be poured into any shape.
Oh, what would the absolute worst building material be?
Jell-O? But nobody would ever try to build something out of Jell-O.
Huh, or would they? What if you built a house out of Jell-O? Simulation activated. Now, where can I get some Jell-O? At the hardware store? No Jell-O here. I get Jell-O at the grocery store? That's a strange place to get building supplies. Whee! I'm gonna need a lot of Jell-O. Jell-O is a dessert made of gelatin that can be formed into many fun shapes. Gelatin is made of long, stringy molecules called collagen. Collagen molecules form a fancy shape called a triple helix. To make Jell-O, you mix the gelatin with hot water, which breaks apart the triple helix shape. As the Jell-O cools down, the triple helix reforms. But now, there's water trapped inside. Like any structure, your Jell-O house would need three basic parts. A floor, four walls, and a roof. Many structures have floors made by filling a mold with concrete and letting the concrete harden. If you built a Jell-O house, you could pour the Jell-O into a floor mold. But when it sets, a Jell-O floor wouldn't be strong enough to hold up a person. Luckily, I can float. The walls would come next. If you built a house out of Jell-O, you would stack blocks of Jell-O, just like you would stack bricks. But unlike bricks, you wouldn't be able to make the wall very tall. If the wall is too tall, the Jell-O bricks at the bottom would get squished. The roof would be the most difficult part if you built a house out of Jell-O. With no internal supports, the best way to make a Jell-O roof would be to make one giant Jell-O block and carefully place it on top of the walls. This doesn't look very stable. Done! Now, let's see what happens to a house made of Jell-O. Uh-oh! If you built a house out of Jell-O, it wouldn't last very long. Gelatin has a low melting point and transforms from a solid to a liquid when it gets warm. If you built a Jell-O house, it would melt on a hot sunny day. Look out! Without any internal struts and supports, nothing is holding the Jell-O house together. If you built a house out of Jell-O, the wind could blow your house over. But the biggest problem would be everyone from ants to raccoons to neighborhood children eating your sweet, delicious Jell-O house. You were right, Structurefriend. Jell-O is the worst building material.
But it is the most delicious. Bye, Cosmo!
Goodbye, Structurefriend. Which chapter should I research next?
Cosmo!
Hey everyone, Cosmo here. Jell-O might not be a good building material for a house, but it is a delicious way to experiment with structures and stability. What if you tried to build a stable structure out of Jell-O? Step 1, find an adult. Step 2, With your adult's help, make some Jell-O or any other gelatin-based dessert. Jell-O jigglers use less water than ordinary Jell-O recipes and are better for building. The recipe is on the box. Pour the mixture into a flat-bottomed pan and let it cool in the refrigerator. Step 3. Once your Jell-O has set, cut it into squares. Step 4. What's the tallest structure you can build out of Jell-O? What's the most stable shape for a Jell-O structure? Step 5. Try shaking your structure to simulate an earthquake. What happened? Step 6. Eat your structure. Yum! Happy building, and I'll see you next time on What If Kids. Goodbye!